Hello and welcome to Old Ways Gardening and Prepping. My name is Teresa. I'd like to welcome you this beautiful, cool day to my backyard. And once again, the plant clearance queen has struck again, and I was blessed with three beautiful bee balms. I got them on clearance for $3.50. There are deals out there everywhere. You just have to look for them. Look what I found, this ancient garden tool, which is just wonderful. I got it at a flea market for $1. Yes, it's supposed to have a long handle on it, but what I'm thinking about doing is I'm going to tape the handle up because it's still in perfect shape. And I'm going to tape it up and I'm going to use it as a hand tool. Alright, now what I'm going to teach you today is how to deadhead these bee balms. Let's see if I can move it where you can see. Alright, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to deadhead these beautiful babies and I'm going to save them. Just in case they were pollinated. And I'm going to show you how I'm going to do it. Alright, you see the dead flower head? And you see back here where there's new growth coming, you're going to snip just above that and save your dead flower head, because just in case if they got pollinated, there'll be seeds in there. And that way I can grow more. And you just snip the stem back to where there's new growth coming. And this is going to encourage them to grow up taller like they're supposed to be. And of course there's dead leaves. You want to clean your baby up a little bit. And of course bee balms are a wonderful medicinal plant as well as a pollinator plant. And see right here, you see the new growth right here? You're going to snip just above it. And that's going to encourage it to bush out and grow up bigger like it's supposed to. Because these are awful short for bee balm. And of course, it's a medicinal plant which you can use to make tea with. All kinds of wonderful things. That bloom head just died, so it's no good. Of course, you're going to clean up all your dead leaves off of it, dying leaves, and let it know that you're going to be welcome here and definitely loved. Especially I will love them because I love bee balm. They're beautiful. And they should be a whole lot taller than they are. But that's okay. We just go through, clean up. And you want to get as much of that dead off of it to rejuvenate it and make it realize, hey, I want to grow better. I want to grow bigger. I want to thrive. I found these at Lowe's, so you might want to check your Lowe's clearance section. Now, when you go down here, let me see if you can see. Okay. When you go down, you want to make sure that, see, this side looks really good. And that'll be your new branches that'll bloom. This side is trying. So I'm going to go down to that one. Okay, this one, they look pretty good. And you just keep snipping and cleaning. Snipping and cleaning and making them look pretty. These were $13 plants. I wouldn't have paid that much for them. But you better believe I'll pay $3.50 for them. It was funny. The lady looked at me. I asked her, I said, can you ring these up and tell me how much they're going to be? And she did, and she said, and I only had one in my basket. And she said, $3.50, and I told her, go ahead, ma'am, ring me up for two more. I'll be heading back to grab the other two here in just a little bit. Now, you see this branch, it has no stem, no leaves on it, but it has new growth right here, snip right up above that. It's got a little bit of new growth on it. You want to clean your plants up to make them healthy. I'm not worried about the beauty factor. I'm worried about their health. And as long as you get all this dead and dying off of them, it'll make them feel better. Okay. Oh, wait, that's got more growing there. Let's get that one off. Let's take that one off because it's dying back. It's got some new growth right here, so I'm snipping all that off. Slowly but surely, it's gonna look a whole lot better. And it's gonna feel better. And it, since all this dead has been pruned off of it, it's gonna want to thrive and grow more leaves. You just want to take the leaves that are dead or dying off of it. And see right here, here's the spent bloom head. And right here is two new stems coming up. Gently snip right between them. And this one, I'm taking it back to right there. It might look partially naked by time. Now see, that's a bloom head that's fixing to bloom. You leave that one on. When you clean them up and make them look good, it'll give them notice, hey, I need to bush out and grow. And these are going to have beautiful pink flowers on them. They had two different kinds. One I should have got anyway, because whoever marked the tag didn't know what they were talking about. But they said that the one was an annual. And I'm like going, Bee Balm is a perennial. And I should have got some of the lavender ones. But I was more called to get these. Thankfully they were fairly moist. And that was only because it had rained. It sure wasn't because they had watered them and cared about them. Okay, take this one back a little further. And see, there's new growth coming there, and you want to be very careful not to disturb that much at all. Just want to make sure you get all the dead and dying leaves off. And I'll bring you back as soon as I get done with this one. Okay, I'm back, and I know some of y'all are going to have a heart attack, but it's something that has to be done. And see, like I said, it takes a while to do this. You want to take off all dead. And see how this leaf is dying? all dying leaves, anything. You want to clean the root around the top of your pot out of all the rotten leaves. Well, not rotten, but dying and decomposing leaves, because that can cause disease. Here's a stem I need to trim back. But look, let's see if I can get it close enough. Do you see all of the new life that's coming out? Let's see if I can turn it. All the new life, the new shoots and everything. And there's another leaf that's dying. It takes time. You have to look underneath the plant. Bird's eye view, slowly spinning around in front of you. But look at all the new growth that's coming. And now it's going to get airflow. There's another one. It's going to get airflow. All this new growth is going to be able to get sunlight. And it's going to be happy. It's going to thrive. And it's going to take off, and it's going to live a good, long, healthy life for many, many years. It's not for the weak of heart, because you don't want your plants looking like death and destruction. And see, you just have to keep looking. Just imagine if this was your body. And you're trying to grow, and you're trying to thrive, would you want a whole bunch of either dead, almost dead, barely dying, things still attached to you, or would you rather have that off of you so that all the new growth can grow and thrive and be beautiful and feed the bees, the butterflies, the hummingbirds, as well as you can make medicinal tea with it as well. It is a wonderful medicinal plant. It might look horrid now, but she's going to live and she's going to be happy. Now, I will bring you back when I get the other two done. They might not end up looking this bad, but I have extreme high hopes that she is going to thrive and be wonderful. Now you want to trim, like I said, your stems back. See the new growth right here? As close as possible to the next new growth. And don't worry if you have one, a stem break off like this one. Because down here, there's roots already growing. Stick it in a pot with some dirt and she'll grow. She'll grow roots and she'll thrive and you'll have another plant. You can grow bee balm by seed, by transplants, by rooting them yourself. They're just wonderful, beautiful plants, and I love them. And I'm looking forward to seeing these three girls thrive and grow up and get off their slug. You never know what you'll bring home from Lowe's, apparently, critter-wise. But as soon as I get the other two done, I will bring you back and let you see what they look like. And then I'll take you along to plant them, because I've got to figure out where I'm going to plant them. But I'll see you after a while. Everyone take care. Okay, I finally have the bee balm all cleaned up and ready to be planted. I'm going to put them in one of my raised cinder block beds, along with a yarrow, one of the other yarrows that I had left over, and planted here along with the ginger. All right, let's get busy planting. Turn it so y'all can see. And since I found out they're going to be dwarf varieties, unfortunately, this is going to be the perfect spot for them. course, you want to be really gentle with them. And like I said, you're root bound or things. And of course, my soil is already amended. And I'm gonna have to add more soil to the bed later this fall. Of course, the ginger is not a perennial here. So this fall, I will harvest the ginger before frost, and then I'll add more soil to the beds to bring them up back up to the level, because everything broke down nicely. And this will be their permanent home. Four things root down. Okay, that's two in. One more to go. Move y'all around so I can get in. Make sure you can still see. And they cleaned up very nicely. So the roots realize that they can spread out, they're going to be a whole lot happier. And now I'm going to water them in. Once they hit those nutrients, they're going to be happy campers. And those roots will start spreading out. The plant's going to bush out, and it's going to be beautiful. We were supposed to get more rain, but the skies are clearing out. So since I'm already watering, I'm gonna take time to water my ginger some more. And I said I'm gonna water. Once the air pockets get out of the lawn, and things will start bothering like they're supposed to. And the bee balm, of course, can take some shade, but it prefers full sun, and full sun is absolutely where it's going to be at. And that's the yarrow that I got on clearance and had to cut back and clean up, and see, it's already fixing the blooms for me. Okay. See how simple and easy that was? Now I'm going to have Dwarf Bee Balm now. Try to rescue as many plants as you can, because they will give back to you in gratitude. They now have a happy home from now on. Well, at least for as long as I live, and they decide to live. I hope you find this video encouraging and motivating, and it encourages you to also rescue those clearance plants like I do. And please click the like and subscribe button so you can come along on other adventures as well, rescuing plants, taking care of many things. It's a blessing in so many ways. Please click the bell notification so you'll be notified when I upload another video. Everyone take care. Go outside. It's early morning here. It's wonderfully cool out here. A little bit of humidity, but it's the south. It's going to happen. Everyone take care. Have a blessed day, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video.